media now, television, is fascinated with Washington, D.C. and politics. It feels like two-thirds of the shows on television these days are about Washington. When you look at them, is there one that you think is the most accurate? Like, is House of Cards accurate, or Veep, or Game of Thrones is pretty much about Washington?
Well, I'm a great believer in free speech.
Right.
And I defend the right of people to say obnoxious things about me and everybody else. But if I was going to make an exception, I would ban House of Cards from being shown. It is the most inaccurate, misleading, and unfortunately, it gives people a bad idea. We suffer from people saying, what's the point of voting? It doesn't do any good. None of them can be trusted. And House of Cards just reinforces all of that inaccurate impression. The best show ever done about politics was West Wing, because it showed people. One good friend of mine, Congresswoman Shelley Pingree, said about House of Cards, first of all, we're not that evil. Secondly, we're not that clever. Everything is always working out this way.
Yeah.
I mean, if the guy from House of Cards was in the escape room, he'd have been out of there in a minute and a half.
Yeah.
Which isn't real life.
Yeah.
In West Wing, you saw real people trying to do the right thing and stubbing their toe and getting it wrong and then getting it right. So West Wing was by far the best. House of Cards is negative. I don't watch a lot of the others, to be honest.
Right. Well, Frank Underwood on House of Cards is like sneaking out of the White House to murder people. And then sneaking back in. And no one's on to him. He's pretty good.
And unfortunately, people get their views of what reality is from watching that.
Right.
And if you watch things like that, then I can understand why people say, well, what's the point of voting? It's all terrible.
Right, and you get the cynicism. Your book is fantastic. In your book, you talk a lot about how you are naturally drawn to the underdog. Your entire life, starting when you were a kid, what was that all about? What do you think?
Well, you don't like to psychologize yourself, and I like to think I did it because it was right. On the other hand, I can't discount the possibility that my attraction to helping minorities is based in part on my being a gay left-handed Jew.
Right, right.
I mean, there are not many majorities of which I am a member, so it's become self-defense at some point.
Well, you take yourself to task for it. Use the word coward. You say that it took you a while to come out and say that you were gay, and you call yourself a coward for that. But at the same time, you never did anything to impede progress for
right. I had a chance to get elected to the state legislature. I very much wanted to try and make things better in the world. I knew, this is 1972, that if I was honest about being gay, I would never get elected. So I made two decisions. One, I would be a coward. That is, I never lied about it, but I wouldn't tell the truth about myself, which was somewhat cowardly. On the other hand, I made this decision I would never be a hypocrite. And I have absolute contempt for gay men. You generally say gay men and lesbians, but for some reason, lesbians don't pull this crap. Only the gay guys do. It is to get elected to office as a gay man and live as a gay person, but then to cover yourself, support anti-gay activity. That's hypocrisy. The notion that you would live one way and then punish other people through your position of authority because they acted that way, that was awful. So I've always felt, yeah, there's a right to privacy, but that does not become a shield for hypocrisy.